Hello guys, it's the festive season again and Holi is around the corner. You have been requesting for a rasmalai cake recipe for a very long time now. So I thought of making it today because it's the perfect time. Let's get started. So we start by preheating our oven at 160 degrees Celsius and I've also ordered some fresh rasmalai from a store nearby, but you can also make it at home, or if you want a detailed tutorial on how to make rasmalai at home, let me know in the comments below. The next step is to line two cake tins with parchment paper. I've also greased them with butter and dusted them with flour. I'm using two 7-inch round cake tins, but you can also use one of them. Then I'll add some room temperature curd to a large mixing bowl. You can also use yogurt. Then I'll add some caster sugar. You can also use some granulated sugar. And we'll whisk that in properly. Keep whisking both of them until all of the sugar is combined. After all of the sugar is dissolved, I'll add some baking powder and baking soda to this mixture. The baking soda reacts with the curd and makes it really nice and fluffy. Then we are going to let this mixture sit for at least 10 minutes or until the curd is almost doubled in volume, and then we'll whisk in our oil. 10 minutes have passed and you can clearly see that the mixture has almost doubled in volume and the curd has become really foamy. This is the perfect time to start drizzling in some neutral oil. This is vegetable oil, but you can use any other type as well. Make sure to constantly whisk the mixture so that curd and oil can emulsify. It's really important to whisk everything nicely so that you don't get an oily cake afterwards. And of course, this is my classic vanilla cake recipe, which you can also find in my YouTube channel. I'll link it down below. From here on, we'll be making it into a saffron-based sponge. I've recently discovered a really nice product from a brand called Carmine County. And I've tried their saffron paste, which has worked wonders for me. I'm using 1/4 teaspoon of that as it is really strong. But you can also use around 1/2 teaspoon of saffron strand instead. I'm also adding 1/2 teaspoon of elaichi powder or cardamom powder. You can use any brand, but this is also Carmine County. And you can also increase or decrease the amount of these depending on your liking. I'm going to add a splash of vanilla extract as well. You can instantly see that the saffron paste is really, really strong and it has got this beautiful natural color to it. Now it's time for our dry ingredients. I'm going to add my maida or all-purpose flour into a sifter. Now let's add our salt. Salt is an extremely important ingredient when it comes to desserts and baking in general. Now using a spatula, I'm going to gently fold the batter together until all of the flour is combined. Make sure to not overmix your cake batter at any cost. My cake batter is ready and I'm going to add it to my parchment lined cake tins. Our cakes are now ready to go into the oven for around 25 to 30 minutes at 160 degrees Celsius. So our cakes are completely baked and they are out of the oven. I'm going to let them cool completely to room temperature. In the meanwhile, we'll be making some whipped cream for our cake. I'm taking 300 grams of non-dairy whipping cream. I have a detailed video on how to whip cream. I'll link it down below. You can go and check it out. Otherwise, just take 300 grams of non-dairy whipping cream, which is pre-sweetened, and whip it up to stiff peaks. After the cream reaches soft peaks, we'll be adding in 1/4 teaspoon of elaichi powder, some vanilla extract, and some saffron paste. I've added 1/4 teaspoon of saffron paste, but you can also add around 10 to 15 strands of saffron. Now for an optional step, I'll be adding a few drops of yellow gel-based food coloring. Our whipped cream is ready, and I also have here 500 grams of rasmalai, which we are going to layer throughout our cake, and we are also going to decorate our cake with this. Now I'm going to quickly remove as much of rust as possible from the rasmalai. For this cake, we don't need any kind of sugar syrup. Instead, we are going to soak our cakes with the rust which we have removed from the rasmalai. I'm going to break the rasmalai into small pieces, and I'm going to leave 2 or 3 of them for the topping. So I've split my cakes into 4 equal sized cakes using a bread knife. You can also skip this step. Now I'm going to brush a generous amount of this rust on my cake crumb. On top of that, I'm going to add some whipped cream. Then I'm going to place some rasmalai on top of it. I'm going to sprinkle some chopped almonds over it as well. You can also add some pistachios if you want. Then we have to repeat all the same steps, right from soaking the cake into the rust and then applying the whipped cream. And after that, we're going to top it with the rasmalai. For the top layer of the cake, I always like to flip my cake so that the bottom part is on the top. This is done just so that you get a flat surface on the top of your cake and you can apply the frosting much easier. Now I'll be adding the last of my rust from the rasmalai, and you can notice that I've applied all of the rust in the cake, which will make the cake really moist and really soft. I'm going to garnish the cake with some dried rose petals and the rasmalai which we had preserved earlier. Some almonds. Some pistachios. Some kesar strands. So with that, our cake is ready. I'm just going to refrigerate it for around 2 to 3 hours and then we'll cut it. So guys, that was it. I hope that you liked my rasmalai cake recipe video, especially because it's eggless and it's extremely simple to make. Anybody can make this at home. If you don't want to put the elaichi powder, you can also skip it, or else you can also use saffron extract instead of the saffron paste. So I hope you like this recipe, and thank you so much for watching this video.